Hello friends, welcome back to the Coastal Logger channel. And it's almost been around another 1 week I have not posted some video, so I'm extremely sorry for that. I was quite busy again with my lab exams and all that stuff. So for today's video, I thought of doing on my course. Actually, that is a lot of people were asking what are the notes that I can refer for farm day, and what are the other materials I can refer for farm day and all that stuff. So don't worry guys, I'll just explain in brief for first year farm day what and all books are required and what and all materials are enough for you to study actually. So coming up with the basics on the farm day stuff, sorry for the noise disturbances. So on that stuff, actually first subject in first year farm D that you people get usually is HAP, that is human anatomy and physiology. A lot of people feel this subject a bit difficult, but those who were friendly with the subject biology in their PU, they will be very 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 good in this particular subject, because as you all know that HAP indirectly means it consists of all the systems, that is the central nervous system, the respiratory system, reproductive system, urinary system, endocrine system, and cardiac system and all that stuff. So for that, I would recommend you people to refer this book. So this book is Ross and Wilson's Anatomy and Physiology. So this is the 12th edition book. I don't know whether the 13th edition has come. This I referred 3 years back, one of the best books. Whatever you write from this book, it is 100% sure that you'll get the best marks. Apart from this book, on the screen somewhere, I'll show you the pick of the other book which you can refer apart from HAP Ross and Wilson. That is Tora Tora, Principle of Human Anatomy and Physiology. So I don't know whether everyone will like this book because it's very fat and it's not so friendly. So it's okay, but there are a lot of pictures. Those who like analyzing pictures and studying for them, it's good. Apart from that, there's another book, that is Agarwal. So that's one of the best book if you ask me, because a very less content and very 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 good information is there. Written by two people, I guess, Rohini Agarwal and Neeraj Agarwal. So these are the books for HAP. Coming up next for pharmaceutics. So pharmaceutics, it consists of completely pharmacy based subject, you can say. It consists of preparing ointments, tablets, knowing about all the preparations, what and all constitutions may be present in that or not there, all that stuff, sucrose syrup, orange syrup and all that in general. Once you enter the course, you'll understand. I would recommend you people, R.M. Mehta book. R.M. Mehta book. So you can see it on the screen. There are two versions, part 1 and part 2. So yellow and green color books. Very, very, very student friendly. You will like it. I would not recommend any other book than these both. So coming up next is another good subject, that is medicinal biochemistry. Very important subject if you ask me. So in this subject, you will study about enzymes and related stuff, ATP. Now coming to what book you have to refer is Satyanarayana book, textbook. It's fat, but it's very 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 useful, and I would like to recommend that book for other years also, in case your pharmacology comes when you're in second year and third year, so you can refer for that purposes also. From that part, we'll go for the POC, that is pharmaceutical organic chemistry. Those who are not good in chemistry, I would recommend you, strictly recommend you, not to join the course of pharmacy, because you will find it very difficult. I myself am not good in chemistry, but I am managing right now, and no more chemistry subjects anyway, so I'm happy for that. So because I'm right now in fourth year, so for this, I would recommend you people to go for the textbook Morrison and Boyd, one of the best textbooks. It's very fat, but one of the best textbooks, and you don't need to read the entire textbook, only for information purpose or basis, it's good. And coming up next, we have IPC or PIC, that is pharmaceutical inorganic chemistry or inorganic pharmaceutical chemistry, you can say. For this subject, I would like you people to recommend, my first reference would be Pulse publication book for BPharm, which is RGHS affiliated. In our case, in deemed universities, you can usually go for Chetwal book. Chetwal is one of the best pharmaceutical inorganic chemistry books. So these are all the textbooks which you can refer. And some people were asking me whether I have notes of those years. Sorry, I have already passed it to my juniors. So I would like to say that in first year, if you refer these textbooks, it's more than enough. There's no requirement for referring separate stuffs and all that nonsense. So please, please, please don't take a lot of stress and all that stuff. Once you join this course, be free, feel free, and don't have to read 24/7 and all that stuff. I'm seriously telling you. And don't even go to take risk by studying only during exam time. That is more riskier actually. So just study whatever you possible for you, whatever it's possible for you, and don't go for extra knowledge, all that stuff. Whatever is important, study that, write the answers properly, and you'll enjoy the life. So all this information you'll also get it in another channel, that is Pharma Tree. So that's a friend's channel of mine. So about Pharma Tree, in the description I'll put it down, so that you people can go to that channel and also subscribe. So until next time folks, so stay tuned, be with me. I'll try to make more and more car and bike videos, but these days I'm not free. So apart from that, I'm planning to go out somewhere. So on that day, I'm sure that I'm gonna make a video. So stay tuned and catch up with me wherever I am. So bye.